why the need to have art schools, why the need to have disseminators of what the true art forms were, or with regard to saving these art forms, saving these handicrafts which were just dying, which were completely being uprooted. And he would constantly, you know, this, if you look at his writings, if you read his writings, he's constantly arguing that why art forms become important. And he says that art forms are the conception of a race. And when you uproot or when you destroy art forms, you are destroying race conceptions. You are taking a source away, because that is the source in which people are enmeshed. And this is where I think a lot of communitarians would become important. Important communitarians gave a very interesting understanding of the self, which was very different from the atomized notion of the self, you know, because the liberals would say that individuals are atomized being, but the communitarians would say that you can't really treat individuals as atomized, because there's a certain source from which these selves emanate, and this is the cultural source. And Taylor did take this argument forward when he was writing about sources of the self. And Coomaraswamy, it's interesting because Coomaraswamy is exactly making this argument that when you take the culture out of the lives of the people, you have nothing to tell the future generation. You have nothing to guide them from, because these are authoritative horizons. The understanding of the self emanates from the interaction with these authoritative horizons. And these authoritative horizons come in many forms, of which he could say that art, iconography are very important sources. So I think that was the guiding sort of motive in Coomaraswamy's writing at this point of time. And he starts anti-colonial discourse. He sets up an organization in 1907, which is Ceylon Social Review, in which he starts holding lectures. So he takes on himself the responsibility of educating the Sinhalese about the various art forms in Sri Lanka. And he writes this text, which is Medieval Sinhalese Art, as a response to the uninformed, uneducated masses. So this transition is very important, because in this transition you see Coomaraswamy as a writer, as a scholar. And one of the most important things that you sort of see, you know, what are the categories of a thinker? One of the most important categories of invoking somebody as a thinker is what is his contribution to the public life. And his contribution is he starts educating. He starts disseminating. Because that kind of knowledge is not coming from anywhere. Despite the fact that Swadeshi movement is talking about indigenous sources of being and boycott, but he actually engages with the question that why do we need to support the Swadeshi? If you look at 1916, it is also the time when a lot of right-wing understanding is emerging about glorification of one's past or the greatness of one's past. For Coomaraswamy, it is not that glorification. It is not that greatness. It is the, for him, it is the link for us to know who we were. And art forms is the medium of actually connecting, because if you look at his writings in this phase, which is 1913 to 1930, he starts writing extensively on various art forms in India. So why does he do that? Because there's a monolithic, homogenized episteme that comes from the West, of which European and British authors are responsible, and they start writing about various art forms, and they have huge troubles of generalization.